Welcome back to Next Gaming, where we cover everything newsworthy that pertains to games. Starting the show off with a tiny tidbits, it's been revealed Resident Evil 4's remake is going to be roughly the same time as the original. Also, we have word from the producer that Resident Evil 4 will barely have any QuickTime events, so that's a nice surprise to see. Never hated QuickTime events, but I can see the appeal of disliking them. Capcom got a lot of criticism for Resident Evil 3's short playtime, so I'm sure they're trying to make up for that with this. PlayStation Plus's November games have been revealed for the Essential tier, including the LEGO Harry Potter collection and Nioh 2. Not really my shtick, but if you're into it, check them out. Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2's campaign reviews are in, with mixed reviews, some complaining that it didn't hold up to expectations under even Modern Warfare 2019 standards. Honestly, we're just going to have to wait and find out if it's a true step down from its predecessor. I think it's honestly going to be a good time. Five-hour campaign, a lot of action, hopefully, not too much drama or cringiness. But overall, I'm gonna hold off on looking at reviews, really. I've looked at a couple and seen a couple videos, but they started to spoil it for me, so I held back. As for trailers, we got a couple, starting off with Paranormal Tales, a body cam style horror game. All we see is a man trying to find his dog in the woods, but it quickly takes a horror turn, and we see this wicked witch. I can't wait to see the final product, see if it holds up. This kind of looks like a pre-alpha-ish, but wishlist it. It's on Steam now, so can't wait. Alan Wake also got a comparison video. It's popped up on the internet. It's very embarrassing, I have to say, but gamers have seen worse from the console in the past few years, sadly. So, I mean, it just goes to show you that Nintendo should be priming up for their next major console in the next couple years, at least a Switch Pro, something along those lines, because it's not terrible. I would really like to see a comparison between the 360 and the Switch, but, you know, it is what it is. The Switch isn't that powerful. Alright guys, on the juicy bits of the show, fans are worrisome about Silent Hill 2 having timed exclusivity to PlayStation 5, stating it might not find its ideal consumer base by doing so. At the very least, it won't help, but I'm sure this is going to be an all-around hit, and with the PlayStation 5 apparently having a threateningly higher install base than Xbox, I'm sure all is well. This is coming to PC, by the way, so I mean, Xbox fans are just going to have to suck it up for a year. This is how the gaming industry goes. I've always believed in a form of exclusivity drives sales. And so this is just a year. It ain't that crazy to think around. You know, it's not like it's going to kill the game. And basically, it's going to give it two releases, Xbox and then everybody else. CD Projekt Red has also announced that a remake of The Witcher is under development. Still no word on The Witcher 3's next-gen version that's supposed to come out this year, but this is great. I never got a chance to play the original Witcher, so I'm hyped to get, you know, into an updated version of, you know, possibly topping the Witcher 3's graphical capabilities. But, you know, I can't wait to see more. But there's a ton of Witcher projects they got under development, plus they're doing another Cyberpunk, so hopefully CD Projekt Red can really knock these out of the park and not have any more issues. And in the show off today, Phil Spencer also revealed in an interview that's circulating a lot of eyes that at some point Xbox will have to raise the price for quote-unquote certain things. Is he teasing a future Game Pass hike or just game prices overall? I don't imagine games being priced past $70 on Xbox and still competing with Sony's, so that's I don't know where he was really going with that other than saying that Game Pass is going to get a hike. You know, let me know below. Would you guys keep Game Pass for, you know, 17, 18 bucks a month? Just a small price hike? God forbid it goes to like 20, 25, but, you know, if it's $20 or $25, I think I might have to consider dropping it because I don't play that many games off of Game Pass. You know, it does have a lot of new titles that I get to demo and see if I would actually buy, but other than that, that isn't much. Anyway, guys, that's today's show. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to join the Wolf Pack. Peace. Oh.